Well, hello there, Gravel fans. Hope you're all having a spiffing Friday. Now, I know you're all still buzzing with excitement after Kalisto's 31st birthday celebrations on 205 Live, but it seems that WWE have overlooked a far more weirder milestone this week. As noticed by eagle-eyed Redditor, Sirius C, kudos to you, friend, yesterday marked a whole year since The Undertaker teased a major return that never f***ing happened on a show where he'd never appear on again. Stripped of his WrestleMania legacy following his 2014 defeat to Brock Lesnar, The Undertaker returned to the 900th edition of SmackDown to strike the fear of God, or the fear of the dead man, to the Survivor Series team. Despite him looking more like an old man yelling at clouds, Team Blue and their bonus cheerleader Edge looked on gamely, part excited, part terrified. Whatever the case, they were all shaking like shitting dogs. Yes, it may have been 2 decades of hard work and toil, but no, The Undertaker doesn't care about his record at the granddaddy of them all. Apparently being on SmackDown and not Monday nights was the thing that he really wanted you to remember, so that's why he's back. I mean, yeah, that makes sense. Totally makes sense. Why would he ever care about something he spent all that time doing? Yeah. He made sure to put over SmackDown Commissioner Shane McMahon first, of course, because of course he did. Shane. Shane is the toughest man in the world. Ever. However, he did then move on to his wider point, which was still slightly unclear. It sounded a little bit like he was going to be taking souls and digging holes and selling t-shirts to the fans who want them. And then, yeah, he moved on to talking to AJ Styles and kind of teased that he might have a match with him that he didn't end up having. It's all quite a bit disappointing, this, really, wasn't it? Yeah. Either way, the crowd goes wild and rest in peace and yada, yada, yada. And then he kind of just disappears off into the darkness to go and chill somewhere. And yeah, it was lovely. Really nice to see him. Thanks for stopping by, Take. Actually, to be fair, he did leave us with a bit of wisdom and said, there's no reason to fear failure, but if you fail, you will have reason to fear. Well, whatever he said, it must have worked, because SmackDown Live eventually ended up winning that match at Survivor Series, which meant the Dead Man didn't have to fight AJ Styles. Whew, thank God, because none of us wanted that match. We all wanted him to have the match with Roman Reigns instead, and thank goodness it turned out the way it did. Ah, lovely. Anyway, that seems like a delightful little end to a delightful little anecdote. I'm Adam Nicholas. Have a fucking great day. Sacrifice.